Breakout boards are a game changer if you ever need to break a larger group into smaller groups. This helps people voice their ideas, provides focus on different problem areas, and helps collect valuable input. Breakout boards are also one of our favorite ways to store documentation for frequent meetings or build idea repositories that the team can reference at any given time. In this video, we're going to learn how to create and work with breakout boards in Lucidspark. Let's start with navigating to More Tools and then click and drag it into our toolbar so we can easily access it in the future. This opens a panel where we'll be able to create and facilitate a breakout board session. Our first step in doing this is to clearly identify an objective for each of our groups. This could be the same task across multiple breakout boards or different tasks for each breakout board. For example, if we're brainstorming team activities, we could create breakout boards asking each group to come up with their favorite team activities, or we can ask the group going to breakout board one to think of their favorite team activities for in-person employees, and then the group going to breakout board two to think of their favorite team activities for remote employees. We can see how both of these help us identify the team's favorite team activities, but with different ways to get there. So let's see how we might set something like this up. We'll first go to our breakout boards panel and click here to create a board within our current one. We'll click join to open it up and then give our breakout board a name. Within this board, we can add templates or create our own prompts and provide structure for our collaborators to participate. When we're done, we can easily move back to the main board by clicking here. Now we'll follow the same steps as before, but customize for remote team activities. And since we know it's going to be laid out in a similar way, we'll right-click on the board we just created and click Duplicate. Now we'll enter the board, give it a name, and make any changes we want. When we return to our main Lucidspark board, we can now see that we have two breakout boards, one to brainstorm in-person team activities and another to brainstorm remote team activities. Once we have our breakout boards created, we're ready to facilitate the breakout session. First, we need to make our breakout boards available to all our participants. We'll do this by clicking Start Breakout. This will open the breakout board panel for all participants. Then we need to separate our team into two groups. For this example, we'll have everyone attending our meeting in person join the in-person team activity board, and anyone attending our meeting remotely to join the remote team activity board. To join their assigned board, collaborators only need to click on the breakout board they were assigned to. Groups are then able to collaborate and complete the objectives they were assigned. As facilitators, we'll be able to see who has joined each group by the icons in the thumbnails. Once all teams have completed their objectives, we can bring them back to the main board by clicking Call Back. When everyone returns to the main board, we can then import each group's ideas from their breakout boards to our main board in two ways. If we wanted to pull the entire breakout board onto the main board to discuss further, we'd select Insert on the board we want to bring over, which will produce a mini visual that we can then move and stick to the main board with a simple click. Now let's say we just wanted to pull over specific items from the breakout board rather than the whole board itself. We can enter the board we want to pull from, select the items we want to copy, right-click, select Copy, and then return to the main board and paste. We can even go a step further by using a direct link. This creates an easy entry point to help anyone access information from our breakout board and reference it in a larger project. For example, if each breakout board was a different sprint, we could directly link those breakout boards to our content roadmap for easy reference and record keeping. We just enter our breakout board, copy the URL, and then paste that URL onto the canvas of our content roadmap. Now anyone with access to our content roadmap could jump into our team sprint boards to get more information on the team's progress. And that's it. You should now be able to create and work with breakout boards in Lucidspark. But this is only the beginning. To learn even more ways you can leverage Lucid in your day-to-day work, visit us at Lucid Training Labs.